Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, the number one place for you to learn about the art and beauty of dividend investing. Welcome to week 20 of the Robinhood Challenge, aka the Dividend Challenge, aka Cherry deposits $200, at least $200 into her dividend investing portfolio every single Monday. And this week is a special week. I again contemplated whether or not I should make a video on this day, because it is actually not all rainbows and butterflies. Let's dive deep. My portfolio value of the day is $17,898.88. So today, by the day, I am actually down by $224.03, down by 1.24%. And this is after hours drop. This has nothing to do with like during the business hours, and I have no idea what tomorrow's gonna look like. But this goes to say that life is unpredictable, and I don't wanna paint like a pretty picture and saying that it's all rainbows and butterflies and you will always gain money. And if you listen to Cherry and follow Cherry's investment strategy, you will always, every single day, gain money. It's not true. That's why I really want to actually show you the whole truth, so that you don't get misled into thinking that investing is just all rainbows and butterflies and it's all gains every single day, because the nature of the game is that there will be volatility. In the short run, there will be volatility. Your day-to-day activity will have volatility. There will be ups and there will be downs. And so you have to have a strong heart to bear all of this. So by the week, I am also down by $148.67, down by 0.82%. And then by the month, I am up by $485.12, up by 2.79%. By 3 months, I am up by $1,496.39. And then it is up by 9.12%. In the 1 year chart, I'm up by $2,664.65, up by 17.49%. And this is significantly lower gains compared to what I showed last week. So here's a screenshot of last week. You can see the difference. And honestly, this is normal. I expected the market to have some downturn at some point, because that's the nature of investing. It's not gonna be all gains, especially if you look at it every single week. You will see times when it is going down. And then in my all-time charts, I'm down again. No breaking even this time, but I'm down by $120.11, down by 0.67%. But this, compared to my many weeks ago video that showed thousands of losses, this is still better. So you can see definitely an upward trend ever since I started doing the Dividend Challenge or Robinhood Challenge. And of course, there is a whole playlist of my dividend investing journey where you can see my starting point, which is $10,000, and that is after I lost a bunch of money in the MJ sector and cryptocurrency. And you can see that compared to now, which is actually almost breaking even again. We're back at it. And I have the buying power of $27.59. So let's take a look at my history. Oh yeah, unfortunately, I don't have any free stocks to open, but yeah, use my free link if you want a free stock. There is the free stock from Robinhood, and there's also the M1 Finance link, which supports this channel. And once you deposit $1,000 to kickstart your account, if you look at history, all right, let's start from the 6. My ICE, it timed out. I did not reach my limit price, so it was canceled. And then there is my Twitter that I limit sold and canceled because it did not reach my price point. And then I market sold my Twitter because honestly, I only have one share of Twitter. I'm really trying to Marie Kondo my portfolio and not have like a bunch of stocks in my portfolio. That's why I sold Twitter. And also, I feel like there are better value stocks out there than Twitter. That's why I sold it. And then there is also ELF limit buy, got canceled because did not reach my price. And then I have a bunch of limit sells. I have Team, I have Fidelity Information System, I have Under Armour, Alteryx, DocuSign, and this is a free stock that I got. Universal Holding, and then this is Cisco, and then General Electric, ELF is a limit buy that I placed, and then I will receive dividends from BOTS tomorrow. BOTS is the robotics and artificial intelligence ETF, and then that is $0.06 for my two shares. And then limit sell of Hyatt, I feel like, I mean, this is one of those stocks that I've held for a long time. It did not grow as fast as I wanted it to. And at the price of $87, I feel like I can make better usage of this money. So that's why I'm limit selling this. And then there is also AGNC dividend $1.92 from my 12 shares. And then there is my Main Street Capital dividend $2.05. And then here's my Realty Income $3.19. And then there is my Stack Industrial 4 shares for 48 cents. And then there is my Occidental Petroleum $4.74 for my 6 shares. And then there is my Stewart Capital $2.80 for my 8 shares. And then there's my APLE Hospitality REIT, 2 shares, 20 cents. And then there's my Disney dividend, $2.64 for my 3 shares. And then there is also my Cisco, 35 cents for my 1 share. And PSEC, 18 cents for my 3 shares. So that is my Robinhood portfolio. Don't go yet because I have 2 more portfolios to show you guys. By the way, a plug if you want a drip case that reminds you of dividend reinvestment plan. Definitely get it in my info box. So this is my M1 Finance portfolio. This portfolio, I only started Q3 of 2019 in September, the day before my birthday. So right now I am up by $244.37, up by 8.49%. And then you can see over here, here's like the upward slope that looks really good. My net cash flow, which is the money I put into this portfolio, is $4,761.41. My market gains is $200.93. My total gain is $244.37. And that is because I have my earned dividends of $43.44. Currently, I have the cash balance of $1.05. And then if you want to support this channel, definitely use the link in the info box. And even if you just want to get 20 bucks for free, just use my link and you will get 20 bucks for free into your M1 Finance portfolio. But if you use the 20 bucks link, it's not as good as using the no money link. But yeah, just pick your poison. But either way. And you can see over here, I have 2 main sections. I have my passive income and my global dividend. The good thing about M1 Finance, as I mentioned many times in the past, but in case you're new to my channel, is that M1 Finance does automatic dividend reinvesting, which means you can be very passive with your investing and you don't have to actively look for stocks, like new stocks to buy every single day, and you don't have to watch the stock prices because everything is just so automatic and you basically allocate, like let's say you have 100% of your money, however much money you have, and you allocate a certain percentage of that pot of money into different stocks. Even if you don't have over 1,000 to buy into Amazon, which Amazon stock is over 1,000, even if you don't have that amount of money, you can still invest in Amazon stock. So that is the beauty of M1 Finance. And of course, fractional shares, that goes without saying because you can buy fractional shares, you can buy fractional shares of Amazon, and dividend reinvesting just basically means when you receive dividends, it gets reinvested back into your portfolio. And you can see that with DRIP, dividend reinvestment plan. DRIP DRIP. So this is the power of snowballing your wealth, power of dividend reinvestment plan. So back to my portfolio, you can see over here, there's the passive income and global dividend, different slices. My biggest slice is passive income. This is one that I customize and bolt. And then there's also the global dividend, which is one of the expert pads that I just put it in just to test the waters and see how it performs. And you can see that it's actually performing better than the slice that I made as of right now. If you click into passive income, you can see that I have some losers. I have real estate, which is a loser, and no, I guess it's just real estate. So I just have real estate as a loser, and I think it's a good buying opportunity if you want to buy into any of these like real estate stocks and REITs. Of course, do your own research, do your own due diligence, because this way, only this way, you can be super confident with your investments and not be altered by external forces. I've lost so much money because I listen to like pro tips and people telling me to buy or sell, and mistakes and lesson learned, really hard lesson. So I lost money. I just want to let you know why I lost money and how to avoid losing money, and that is with doing your own research. And even if you were to lose money, you have no one else to blame. But yeah, most of the time people lose money because they don't do research and they just get easily persuaded to buy and sell. Now let's take a look at, I have Realty Income, LTC Properties, Simon Property Group, Wall Tower, Store Capital, Annaly Capital, NRZ, APTS, and Iron Mountain Incorporated. And if you want to see all the stocks in my M1 Finance portfolio, go to this link because I show all of that. And I also show off my Robinhood stocks, which is a ton, in this link. So be sure to check that out. And then let's look at my biggest winner. My biggest winner as of right now is tech. I am not surprised at all. I am so bullish about tech. So within my tech sector, there is Microsoft, Apple, Tesla, Broadcom, Cisco, Amazon, Alphabet, Visa, Alteryx, and Slack. And by far, what is the best performing? That's total gain. So Tesla, definitely total gain. Ooh, up by 60 something percent. I regret not having more in Tesla, but I mean, yeah, I at least have a share of Tesla, all right? Yeah, in my other portfolio, not this one, but imagine how big this number would be if my portfolio is like super large, then this number is gonna blow up real time, like real big. And perfect example, Amazon stock price. Let's just look at Amazon stock price. $1,862, that is Amazon stock. So imagine like, just to buy one single share of Amazon stock, just to be able to buy into one share, you need like almost 2K. If you don't wanna put 2K of your money into Amazon, definitely use M1 Finance because you can track the progress of the stock and it's been up 10.38% the time I put my money into this. And another thing good about M1 Finance is that you can see I only have a dollar and something in cash, which is not substantial at all. But for Robinhood, if I receive a bunch of dividends, I have like, let's say $27 right now, and I can't really use this money unless I actually actively find a stock that is priced perfectly at 27 or under in order for me to buy into it. But a lot of the times, well, first of all, time is wasted by doing all those extra research, and a lot of the times you can't even find the perfect stock priced at the perfect dollar amount that fits with your buying power. So that's why it is so helpful to have M1 Finance. So that is up with my M1 Finance. Let's take a look at my Webull account. So this is my Webull account. I have Tapestry, Nokia, McDonald's, Alteryx, Bank of America, and AT&T. Not much has changed, and my account value is $843.81. I have the unrealized P&L of $41.92, up by 5.23%. And I also received Tapestry a dividend of $5, and also McDonald's a dividend of $1.25. And this goes into my cash balance, which right now I have the cash balance of $60. So that is my Webull account. If you're interested in receiving free stocks, be sure to check out my info box where I will have all the links to everything that you need, including my personal finance course and everything in between. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and please thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that bell notification. You know the drill, and I will see you in my next investing video.